On the 12th of July, we honor Saints Louis Martin and Sally Martin, who were a French Roman Catholic couple. They are best known as the parents of Saint Therese of Lisieux, but they are models of holiness in their own right. In 2015, the couple were canonized as saints, becoming the first spouses in the Church's history to be canonized as a couple. Most saints' feasts are celebrated on the day on which they died and entered into heaven. The feast of Saints Louis and Sally Martin is an exception to the rule. Their feast is celebrated on July 12th because it is the day on which they were civilly married, with a religious ceremony taking place at midnight on July 13th, as was common for couples who wanted a quiet service where they could receive communion. The Martins were holy people who lived with true and contagious devotion for the Lord. But while today we can see that marriage and family life were certainly their vocation, the path to their sainthood wasn't as linear as one might think. Louis was born in 1823 in Bordeaux. Although Louis intended to become a monk, wishing to enter the Augustinian great Saint Bernard Monastery, he was rejected because he did not succeed at learning Latin. He instead settled to become a watchmaker. Zélie Guérin was born in 1831. She too hoped to become a religious, but was turned away by the Sisters of Charity of St. Vincent de Paul due to respiratory difficulties and recurrent headaches. She eventually understood that it was not God's will and became a successful lace maker instead. Louis and Zélie met in Alençon while passing each other on a bridge, fell in love, and were married in 1858 after a 3-month courtship. It's been recorded that when Zélie first saw Louis, she heard our Blessed Mother tell her that this was the man she was to marry. For almost a year, the couple lived as celibates, but the advice of a confessor changed their minds and encouraged them to enter fully into married life. They decided to raise as many children as possible for the glory of God. Zélie gave birth to 9 children, 5 of whom grew to adulthood and entered the religious life. Their youngest was Saint Therese of Lisieux. Their third child, Mary Leonie, was declared Servant of God in 2015 and is a candidate for sainthood. The family lived a comfortable lifestyle, but they also suffered the loss of 4 children at an early age and had to deal with a rebellious daughter. Zélie's various letters written in her lifetime revealed that daily life was challenging for her. She was raising young children, mourning the losses of her 4 children who died young, running a business, all the while trying to care for her marriage and stay close to the Lord. Their devotion never wavered, however, and the series of tragedies only intensified the love of Louis and Zélie Martin for each other. The couple lived modestly, reached out to the poor and the needy, and led daily prayers in the household. Saint Therese would later write, "God gave me a father and a mother who were more worthy of heaven than of earth." In 1877, at age 45, Zélie Martin died of breast cancer. Louis then moved the family to Lisieux to be near his brother and sister-in-law, who helped with the education of his 5 surviving girls. Gradually, his daughters left to enter the convent and his health began to fail. "Despite his loneliness," he said, "it is a great, great honor for me that the good Lord desires to take all of my children. If I had anything better, I would not hesitate to offer it to him." Louis died in 1894 after suffering greatly, including a 3-year stay in a psychiatric hospital. Louis and Zélie Martin were beatified by Pope Benedict XVI in 2008 and canonized by Pope Francis in 2015. They are the patron saints of marriage, parenting, and widowers. Placing all our petitions before them today, let us pray. Blessed Louis and Zélie Martin, today we turn to you in prayer. by fulfilling the duties of your state in life and practicing the evangelical virtues as spouses and as parents, you have modeled for us an exemplary Christian life. May the example of your unwavering trust in God and your constant willingness to surrender all the joys, the trials, the sorrows and the sufferings that filled your life encourage us to persevere in our daily challenges and to remain in joy and Christian hope. Amen.